Changing the motor in the Cox Skyranger is a fairly simple process. First, remove the wing from the body of the aircraft and also remove the propeller. Now take a look inside the body of the plane and you'll see a wire that comes from the motor and then attaches to the main circuit board. And take note of the orientation of those wires. The red wire should be toward the back and the black one toward the front. And then go ahead and pull that loose to disconnect it from the main circuit board. Then turn your attention to the front of the plane. On either side of the propeller you'll see a very small black screw. And you'll take both of those screws out using a small Phillips head screwdriver. Once the screws are out, you'll see that the motor retention plate is loose. And at this point, you can remove the motor from the body of the aircraft. Normally, you'll find it difficult to pull the engine out, so you might have to push it from the rear. And to do that, use something long and thin like a screwdriver or a pencil. Now you can go ahead and put the new motor in the same way you took out the old one. The one thing you have to be sure of is that the motor is oriented properly before you push it in. You'll notice a small bead of solder near the rear of the motor, and you have to be sure that's pointed up because there's a small slot for it in the sleeve where the motor mounts. Go ahead and push the motor in place, and then reattach the motor retention plate with those two screws, and then finally attach the motor to the circuit board. And with that, you're ready to put the plane back in the air.